Welcome back to World of Xeen. First thing I am going to do is go back down here, since all the octopods are dead, and set up a beacon near the fair vampire maiden. Next, I want to go check all those the big section of this castle that I just didn't go to. And I'm level, what, 50-ish now? Yeah, I should be pretty much set for a good majority of the rest of the game. Should be. You know, there's the possibility that I'm just gonna stop lying to you right now. It's not gonna matter too much where we're going. But yeah. Because strange thing. There's a puzzle coming up that, upon completing, well, doing it, there was a, their number responses, and I was using my keypad. Thing with my keypad is one of the buttons stops and starts the recording. And, yeah, I pushed it. No, I don't know what this room is for. Maybe there's a pit I didn't encounter. So we want to ring this, so we can go in here. I don't know what that other little room is for. I couldn't even tell you. Do nothing here, except for a coffin that has nothing in it. Kind of irksome that you have to be facing a certain way for it to open. Apparently all of them you need to be facing north for. Now, let's try that. Oh. That would have been handy had I known it earlier. Nah, let's just go up and kill him. Not tough anyway. And this one's south. I don't know. A pendant, probably useless. Yeah, you guys aren't exactly scary, are you? At least I can search in any direction, but I can't do the other ones. Go figure. Zarkon the Great really screwed up the teleport this time. Struggling up the ladder, vampire grabbed for his ankles, and he fell and popped like a jelly donut. Well, that's a wonderful visual. How about no? So that takes care of that little section. Yeah, we need to go back to Castle Calindra, don't we? I talked to her and got the combination. Why did I go into town?
Okay, go ahead.
Hopefully it doesn't password me. So I need to go upstairs and into her items. Now this was not 64, that's not even in this combination. And get her crown. Yay! And now our will is strong enough to reverse the curse of the vampire. That's some really strong will there. Key to the pyramid and 5,000 experience. You can go back to Ambrose and talk to him. But it won't matter. It won't give you anything else. So, I need to go to that pyramid that we saw. Now, this is where I accidentally hit my key that stops and starts the recording. There it is. Yeah. Couldn't go in here before. Make sure you backpedal. In fact, what am I doing? Is the sound on, or am I just really, really low? No, it's on. Alright. Use that, but take the time to cast the real one. You need cold and fire. Trust me. And I'm gonna sidestep, because I'm a scared baby. Now remember, that is with a ton of resistance, protection from elements, at, you know, 57 times 2 is 114, and yeah, it's really, really painful. So we don't need items too much. I kind of wish I had cold resistance, but I don't, sadly. Well, I can go pick up a, there's a cold resistance thing somewhere. There goes Tabitha. Pick up a, cold shrine. That probably would help a great deal. I don't know how much the damage they do currently, but holy hell is that painful. I want to kill all of them too. I think this is the only level of the pyramids that has enemies in it. Wow, man, I'm really out of power cure. Should have just rested. So, even though I have almost 1200 SP, it's not enough. Well, at 114 a pop, of course it's going to, you know, disappear quite quickly. And you do want fire, trust me. There are fire-type dragons in this area. That was dumb. Yeah, it's painful here. Actually, I'm not sure if you cast protection afterwards, it'll override it. Like, turn it from double the pointage to half the pointage. I don't know where this guy is. There he is. It's probably more. No? Really? Oh no, there's one more. It didn't move on me though. Kind of strange. Yeah. The whole tactics with dragons, which you would have learned if you did Cloudside anyway. Well, you might not have learned it, but I definitely would hope that you did. It makes things a lot easier. Dragonfire was currently indisposed, but a staff member will be with you shortly to discuss whatever business they had in the... Does he mean the dragons that I'm currently slaughtering? Yeah, moonwalking is your friend. That goes up, and Cloud Dragon. Trust me, getting rained with his death beams are not pleasant at all. I don't remember how much damage they do. It's probably a few hundred. That's my guess. But remember how to control the game. I'm gonna have to rest again. Also, reception. Very cold reception. I'm sorry, that joke is terrible. It's the second time I've made it, and it's still bad. Although the first time it was delivered much better. Ugh. I think this is the only level with monsters on it. This is a green dragon. Oddly, they don't do poison damage. They do fire. A little bit odd. sure there's no more. And this, I think, is the, yeah, it's the Overseer's office. So as long as you know how to fight dragons the correct way, the kind that doesn't get you murdered, you'll be alright. Enter the 8 numbers to pass the test. They are in a row, so do your best. So 8 numbers in a row. Yeah, you can see that this is indeed the part that I messed up. Damn it, they're still here. Smallest even. No, 8 in a row. Smallest even. True, that's wrong. There's more clues to be had. Make sure we do the moonwalking thing. There's no more? Don't believe you, game. I really don't believe you. I hope that's it. These guys are painful. No? I'm gonna have to recharge you again, aren't I? Do. No. Can't switch that. So 8 numbers in a row, and they total 52. So the, you know the answers are 8 numbers in a row, and they add up to 52, so they're going to be small. Now if you want, you can go check. You can go, okay, what's 1 plus 2 plus all the way to 8, and okay, that doesn't work, 2 to 9, that doesn't work. And then you try 3 to 10, and it would work. Or you could do it this way. You know, just enter the numbers randomly. That's assuming you've hit that one, so that's 3. I'm the largest prime. That's not 10. That is not 9 or 8. It's an even number. Of course it doesn't work. So 7. I'm the smallest even. That would be 4. In this case. Huh? Oh, you're twice. Alright. I didn't read it. I thought it was just that was the smallest even. Wait a second. Okay, so I've used 8, 3, and what was the other one? Oh, 7. Largest prime and all that. I'm the smallest square, that's 3. Squaring 3 times 3 is 9. You know, minor math at this point. I'm the largest, what is my number? 10. That was the part that messed me up. Because the 0 is actually my stop and start record button on my number pad. I'm the smallest even, that would be 4. I've done 10, cross that out. Now that one says which number is left. I don't know yet. Let's get the pencil out of my hand since it's messing me up. I am the smallest prime number that's left. That is, of course, assuming that you've already done the 3-1. So all that's left is 6. So that's open. Now, we go back, hit this switch, and it opens up something really nice. Just a pile of treasure with 2.5 million in it. And 5,000 gems, which I don't really need. Gold is nice, though. It replaces all that money I spent on training earlier. Obsidian cudgel and saber. I guess? You don't really need it. But sure. I don't think I'm ever going to get better, ranged weapons, though. Now, cutlass is 2 to 8, and saber's 4 to 8. It's only 2 points, but I'm going to take it. Well, that pretty much takes care of this level. Now, if you've hit all the switches, you should be able to go up a level. That's not the way, that's the cold reception and bad jokes. Do-do-do-do-do. Did I miss one? Where the heck did I miss one? Got that one. There's no switches in here. There's none in the dragon houses. Where did I miss one? I got that. Oh, I didn't go up north. Alright. Thinking I lost it. Going crazy or something. Don't forget to light the 6 torches before trying the stairs, or as better known, the switches. No. This room should be full of death. Hopefully not mine. At least when I can hit them, I'm quite safe. Alright, so Holly's missing a bunch, Bob's missing a bunch. They should be alright though, that's really bad. Alright. Hopefully that takes care of them. Nope, one more. There goes Bob. That's alright though. During the creation, blah blah blah, 312 years ago. Anyway, last switch that I didn't have before. Now, I don't need my abilities anymore, my combat abilities. I do, however, am going to need jump. Eventually. Now, this place is interesting. Total the dates is all you have to do, then minus 32. Sick of doors. This is a 1. There are 3 numbers here. This is 1776, Declaration of Independence. This is 1492, day Columbus sailed the ocean blue, and 1993, which at least the date of this game, I guess? I don't know. It doesn't matter a whole bunch. I don't know what that little nugget's for. I don't even know why I bothered trying to open it. Now take your answer, divide by 3, your mission is set to... Number 42, final number can get you through. Type in the passcode. Now, there are 2 hints for this number. There's the math one, that you've gone through, and you could figure out the number from there. Or you could read this, Starfleet Registry Number NCC. This is a Star Trek reference. So, if you don't know Star Trek, you can figure it out through some math. Or if you do, you don't need to go in that room at all. So there's that. This place is really annoying. I will show you why. This took a little bit of time to get through my previous time. You walk forward, do-do-do-do-do-do, oh, I'm in the outer lane. So, you need to teleport. There's more of them. Like, this one is right before the corner. They are designed in a staggered fashion that if you mess up and you keep pushing forward, you will teleport all the way to the outside, which is incredibly annoying. Is this one at the corner or right in front of me? I don't remember. Ah! Yeah, it was a lot easier going through the second time. access denied. You know? But, again, finally, the Dragon Pharaoh. We only picked up his orb at, what, part 23, and here it is at 36 or something. Though I dare not leave. But that's enough of that. Amara uses Xeen to... Yeah, we already figured that out. Talking to the giant dude will not destroy Xeen, but everything will lay dying cold. Strength of... Oh, we're already going? Oh, so that's why he pretty much imprisoned you in your own pyramid, isn't it? He says northeast. He doesn't mean it. He actually means northwest. Yeah, he does. This, don't drink from that. Ever. It will just kill you, I think. I don't think there's any way to become powerful enough to not be eradicated by it. Yeah. So... So we can't go up, but we have that mission. He has told us that we need to go into... Well, you'll see. I don't think I've shown it thus far, though. Where the heck is Town Portal? It's an alphabetical order RPG. Go here. He said northeast. He actually means northwest. Already discussed this. Make sure you go around the Pond of Damage. Right here. Normally you can't get in here, but now that we've met the Pharaoh, and have his orb and all that, we can get in. Doesn't this look familiar if you've watched the entirety of the Might Magic 3 LP? It does. Now, if you go here, activate this, and use these statues, anything below 50 has been raised to at least 50. Now, if you were doing a min-max run, you'd have to wait to do this. To get everybody's stats all up to 50, and then you can go pick up everything else. I'm not doing that, because that's really freaking annoying. It would have been interesting, though, as far as, viewing... goes, but, eh. The other one does exactly the same thing. It's escape pod, no. Oh, no, it's exit escape pod 1. So that's how we get out. Photon control... sure. Weapon systems. Nothing in it, though. Nothing here. I haven't been here, by the way. Yeah, my other recording this took longer because of the, teleporting bits. Strange energy field? Oh! Starseed Project, Mean Orbit, don't know what any of that means. I'm not a space physicist. Oh, okay, so each number represents... a letter in order. So it's 1 to 26. Just give me a moment. Write it all down so I can figure this out. Because it'll be easier if I set up a little reference sheet than have to figure it out each and every time. Of course, some of these I probably don't even need. That would be really embarrassing if I put them in the wrong order. B, W, X, Y, Z. Alright. So 23 is W. 8 is H. 5 is E. R, E. N, O. Is this what I think it is? It is, isn't it? It is. Second Star Trek reference in the same part. Alternals. Setting course for Terror Project. We were there. In previous LP. And they're still trying to get Sheltum. Schwartz-Heinrich matter transfer device to accomplish Planetfall. Location Varn 4 Kron vehicle. Korak personality module to facilitate. Wow, jeez. Oh, so this is a whole bunch of story. I'm reading it. You should be too. Oh. Yeah, he goes from, you know, being a pain in the butt unto, oh crap, he is freaking evil. Was posing as, oh. So, Alamar is Sheltum? That's our actions in Magic 3. This is a whole lot of story. It doesn't give you much story, and then it's like, here you go, everything that has happened up until this point. Have to physically defeat him. Heading for Xeen. Now what happened to the original group? Oh. That's what happened to them. They are not us, and we are not them, but, we don't know how long it's been between them escaping, apparently. Or, you know, maybe, I don't know. I'm kind of worrying about Mops and whatnot, and Mops and crew at this point. What happened to them? Korak, and he is blue. Yeah. So we need to get you past his defenses so you can defeat him, since we cannot. Huh. So we can't defeat him, but you can. But you can't get to him, but we can. But we need a way to get you to him. Where have we not gone? Well, haven't gone to Necropolis, that'd be a good place to start. We've gone into the thing. We don't need those energy discs. So we cannot defeat Sheltum. Makes sense. Korak can, but Korak can't make it to him because Sheltum / Alamar will drain him of his power and he won't even reach him. And Dragon Pharaoh has the same problem. So we need to get something for Korak to make it to him. Well, Necropolis is right here. And since it's right outside the thing, it might be a good idea. I kind of wonder if the impact caused this mess, the lava and whatnot. It does kind of make sense, you know, something coming from orbit, crashing into it. It's something, you know, that advanced, and it might have actually penetrated the thing to the lava layer. But the only option I have right now on my list of stuff to do is either explore the lava, which doesn't sound like fun at the moment, or go to Necropolis, which I think is my next stop. Oh, it's right next door anyway, so I might as well try. Actually, did I have anybody set a beacon at Dragon Pharaoh? I didn't, did I? I could've. I don't know if I need to talk to him again. Well, gotta find something for Korak to hide in or something. Anyway, until next time. Yay!